네, 와사헬란 하세요.
와사할람?
에, 와사헬란.
와사할람?
에, 살람 알레이쿰 아헬란.
와사할람?
Get up.
Hello.
Hello.
So I met Par today to introduce you because he teach Korean language with Arabic. It's really unique in Korea. So I want to introduce her today to help you to study Korean. At first, I want to learn some Arabic language from her because you know Arabic well. So
yeah.
I want to learn some words. Mm. So how to say hello. I know this. 안녕하세요. 아살라무알레이쿰.
네.
Is it different? 살람알레이쿰 and 아살라무알레이쿰.
아니요. Naturally, assalamualaikum. Assalamualaikum.
Ah, naturally.
It's assalamualaikum, but when you say like quickly, assalamualaikum.
Ah,
yeah.
So it's more natural way.
Or you can say marhaban.
Merhaba. Ah, I heard merhaba.
Yeah, it's near Turkish too.
Yeah, Turkish.
But it's merhaba. From Arabic.
Then how to say kumao? Thank you.
Shukran.
Shukran. Oh, how to say I love you?
Uhibbuk. Oh, uhibbuk.
Uhibbuk.
Or uhibbuki.
Uhibbuki.
Same thing.
Ah, uhibbuk. How to say, I'm sorry.
Asif.
Asif.
네.
Oh, asif. There are formal way and informal way in Arabic?
No.
Oh, it's just, like in English.
Yeah, it's just like English.
Oh. How much is it?
Become hada.
Become hada. Where is bedroom?
Aina hammam.
Aina hammam.
잘 아시네요.
Aina hammam. Hello, I'm Jay Kim and I do YouTube. Nice to meet you.
Marhaban.
Merhaban.
Or assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum.
Ana.
Ana.
Jay Kim.
Jay Kim.
YouTuber.
YouTuber.
예. 아나 유튜버 제이킴.
아나 유튜버 제이킴.
프루사 사이다.
프루사 사이다.
프루사 사이다.
프루사 사이다.
프루사 사이다 라쿰.
프루사 사이다 라쿰. I will ask you to how to say Arabic next time. Yeah, I want to learn Arabic. It's really unique thing because I never heard that teach Korean with Arabic. So
yeah.
That's why I want to introduce her. So I'm going to ask some questions to know her more about. So as far as, can you introduce yourself?
Assalamualaikum. Hello guys. I'm Channa from South Korea. I teach Korean in Arabic for Arab people. So I have my own business from this year. www.koreanforyou.com. Come, yeah, so you can register from my website and learn Korean in Arabic. 비셔키르 사헬. So I have YouTube channel, the name is Channa Korea, and I usually teach Korean in Arabic for Arab people. So, and I also put some videos about like Korean vlog with Arab people or just cooking, anything.
Is that your job teaching Korean?
Oh yeah, I have my own business now, so yeah, it became my job, but I also teach Arabic to Korean people in Korea too.
So I work as a
freelancer.
Yeah, teach Arabic to Korean and teach Korean to Arabic.
Oh yeah, perhaps. Exactly. Yeah.
Oh, that's a really good idea. Oh yeah, I'm curious this. Oh, what made you teach Korean in Arabic?
I majored in Arabic in my university, and when I went to Arab countries for studying Arabic, I was so surprised that Arab people love Korean and Korea is so interested in Korea. I didn't know that. I was so surprised, but the thing was that there was almost no Korean who teach Korean for Arab people only. So I thought, why not? So I started to do that.
Interesting. K-pop is so much popular in Arab world.
Yeah, it's BTS, amazing. Right?
So, thank you. Shukran.
Shukran.
Studying Arabic is not common in Korea. So I want to ask, how did you become interested in Arabic or Arab?
From when I was so young, I really am interested in language, English and Japanese, anything. So, but I wanted to choose something unique as well. And at the time, my boyfriend was from Pakistan, and he recommended me to study Arabic.
That's interesting.
Yeah, that's why I chose Arabic.
Actually, Arabic is deeply related to Islam religion. So,
yeah.
I'm curious that what do you think about Islam and Muslims?
I really found that in our countries that religion is their life.
Yeah,
it's
right.
All about their life. So, but then you know that Islam means peace.
Yeah, yeah, right.
Yeah. I also think the most important thing in my life is about peace. And I think it's really peaceful religion, but like American and media, it looked a bit different.
Negatively.
Negatively. But I'm interested in the culture and the religion as well, so I'm gonna study about it too.
Oh yeah, do you interest in their culture too? And have you ever been any country?
Of course I'm interested in Arab culture. I love it. They're really kind, their food and their culture. But their culture is actually just religion, you know. But it was really different, totally different when I first came there. And I went to Egypt and Jordan for studying Arabic. I also traveled to Morocco and Emirates, Kuwait.
Wow, so many countries. I didn't know that. Wow. How was it?
Wonderful. All countries are really beautiful. You should really visit.
I only went Tunisia.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah. Huh. I'm a singer, so I had concert in there.
Really?
Yes.
Wow. I didn't know that.
It was really good. Yeah, yeah. I love that. Food, weather, people, culture, building.
Yeah,
everything is so beautiful. Mm. In language, what do you think, what is the difference between Arabic and Korean?
Yeah, it's, I think, totally different, I think. And many Arab people find it really, really hard to study Korean. Because, you know, 모음, 하라칸, it's called 하라칸 in Arabic, and we have so many vowels, you know. But in Arabic, there is not like that kind of thing, so it's so similar, like a, o, u, o. So the pronunciation for Arab people for the first time is really difficult, and the grammar also is like totally different, because we Korean always say the subject for the first time, but in Arabic, they put vowels, they put the first.
Oh, it's so, it's different.
Yeah, it's totally different. We always put verb at the end, but in Arabic, they put verb on the first.
And they write in opposite way.
Oh,
they,
yeah.
Not left to right. Right
yeah,
to left.
Right to left.
At first, I was really shocked how to write right to left.
I was shocked too.
Yeah.
For me, it was really hard to study Arabic too.
Yeah, right. It's totally.
I was crying. Really.
But now you can speak them.
Yeah.
Wow, so smart.
No. I cried and studied at the same time.
Can you tell me any like special tips to speak Korean well?
Yeah, many people find it difficult to speak Korean.
Yeah, right. So.
When you want to speak Korean, first you have to listen to a lot like K-pop, drama, or film, like movies. I recommend you guys to listen to a lot and study like regularly, like every day at least like 10 minutes or 15 minutes. And with the good grammar book or from me. I have good
from
system.
Good.
If you're Arab, I can explain Korean in Arabic in a really, really easy way.
Good teacher.
Inshallah. If God wants. Inshallah. When you say something about future, you can say it.
Inshallah.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is the last question. Do you have any future plan?
Of course. My future dream is really big. It's to make a lot of Korean institutes in Arab countries. Also to make institutes in Korea for Arab countries. And so that we can, Korea and Arab community will be more better and more friendly. It's my dream. Not only just Korean education, but like culture by culture, we can exchange culture.
Yeah, right. Language is just not language.
Yeah,
it's,
right.
It's culture, people, and everything, history. So,
right.
Yeah, I hope you will be a good teacher and hope your goals or dreams come true.
Thank you. Shukran.
Shukran. So today I met Janna to introduce you, Korean teacher with Arabic. So I hope it will be helpful. And if you're interested in studying Korean, then go to her channel and try to study Korean steadily. Thank you so much. And
마지막 마살라마.
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 감사합니다.
감사합니다.
네. 금방 끝났네.